Hi. Good evening, everyone. My name is Ben, and this is also my first PK night. Woo! It's also the first one I'm presenting at, so please bear with me. This story, this talk, is rather about community, great word, and how mine has grown from small-time Champagne to what it is today. I also have a lot of stuff to talk about, so I'll try to keep it brief. The story begins here in my senior year of school when I entered the Kudo Plays board game competition. For those of you who may not know, it is where the gamers, designers, and makers of the community group together and build the games that they want to play. While going to all the different events and workshops, I met a bunch of colorful characters, including Tim, whose wardrobe I'm channeling tonight, and Josh, who invited me up here today. My teammates, four other guys, and I made the board game Sabotile by design iterating, prototyping, et cetera, and we made it to the Grand Exhibition. The Grand Exhibition was where we showed off the game publicly, and we actually placed 3 of the 8 judging categories, which made us very proud. We're also very proud to graduate a month after, and it was then that we also showed the game off at our senior show in the Cranon Art Museum. While there and at the Grand Exhibition, we had lots of people asking us, what's the future of this game going to be? Are you going to maybe take it to market or put it on store shelves? And that idea sounded awesome. But how could we do that? Well, there's a buzzword that's going around called crowdfunding, and the most popular platform for that is Kickstarter. So what is that exactly? It's where project creators will upload their ideas out into the public, where backers, people who are really interested and want to see those things happen, will pledge money to them. Now, as we were delving more and more into this research, we realized that a company account was going to help a lot with all that money going into someplace. So that summer, Team Will Get There became a fully fledged limited liability company, Grizzly Forged Studios. But that doesn't end the story there. We had to do tons more research looking into what Kickstarter involves, such as the length of the campaign that we wanted, the different pledge goals, which were essentially the amounts of money that people would put towards the campaign and what rewards they would get in exchange for those, and a slew of other things. Of course, when we graduated, some of us stayed in Champaign and some of us went home, so we were apart, and we had tons of video calls about all those factors that I just mentioned. We also, through Kudo Plays, got to meet a manufacturer and distributor who were going to work with us to both manufacture the game and then distribute it or get it to our backers' homes, whether they be in the US or overseas. That's pretty cool. Let's see. As we continue going, the web of connections grew and grew as we also went to different local game stores to promote our game and just get as many people invested in our project as we could. So our circle, our community that started here in Champaign grew to encompass the whole US, and that was even cooler. As we continued on, we had so many more things that we had to decide, including, but not limited to, the page content of our Kickstarter campaign. So what was going to be on there, how we wanted to portray ourselves, as well as the final funding goal, which is to say the minimum amount of money required for the project to succeed and let us receive it. Basically, it's an all or nothing system. And we were constantly going back and forth with the manufacturer and distributor to get all of these numbers crunched and figured out. Unfortunately for us, we sort of had a falling out with our manufacturer. After hundreds of emails, they kind of realized we didn't know exactly what we wanted, and they sort of dropped us on the wayside, which was kind of awful. We tried to take it in stride, but we were also worrying about so many other factors like artwork. We had to hire a friend of ours to do the beautiful art that's on the game. But luckily, our guardian angel, Zach, who we met from Kudo Plays, was able to swoop in and save the day. So he connected us with a contact of his who, after a meeting with and discussing and receiving a very thorough quote from about what each component was actually going to cost, we decided that we would go with them and launch the campaign. So the campaign launched, and it was 9:30 in the morning, an hour later than we expected, on March 14th, 2016. That's when our first backer, a friend Tucker, pledged $100 to our campaign. And from there, it just kept going. Yes, yeah, by the end of the day, we had received $5,000 in pledges, and we were on cloud nine. It was pretty great. Another unfortunate turn was that that was almost the highest that we got in one day. By the next the end of the next 30 days, we saw a grand total of $16,250, which is just amazing and totally mind-blowing to me. Unfortunately, because it didn't reach our funding goal, which was an even loftier $50,000, we didn't receive any of it, but we did receive a lot more in return. And that is a global expansion. We are now international. We made backers, 300 backers, who represented 10 different countries, and we're hoping to see them back at our next launch, which is pretty cool to say. The Terminator slide was to show that we'll be back. And the reason for that is because we'll come back, yeah, even stronger than before. The sequel's gonna be better than the original. Our network is continuing to grow through the campaign. We actually met a really cool guy. His name is Dave, he's a videographer, but also met a new manufacturer who is going to meet with us at Gen Con and discuss even more about cutting down costs and whatnot. So the moral of the story is, you know, you start small and you just keep getting bigger based on your passion. And for me, the community that helped foster that was Champaign Urbana. So thank you very much for that. to continue on, yes, I feel like whatever circle you're in, people want you to succeed. So it makes sense to make your circle as big as possible, right? With the last couple seconds that I have now, I'd like you to think about your communities, whether they're your family, your friends, or even your local one, and think about what community means to you and how much it means as well. Because the more you give, the more you should get back in return. Thank you. My name is Ben Moy. This is my first PK night, and I am a designer who ran a Kickstarter campaign. I'd love to meet with you guys and be part of your community, so add me on Facebook. We can pacha-kacha later, and let's give it up for the rest of the speakers tonight. Thank you.